In this screencast, I'm going to show you how to develop a simple user form to determine how much you owe the IRS. And actually, this is a couple years old, so tax tables may have changed a little bit. When you click this button, it'll open up the user form. Okay, very simple. You can put in your incomes. Default is 5,000. Calculate your tax. It's going to ask you, are you single or married? Filing jointly. Says your tax this year is $4,953. So that's what we're going to be creating in this screencast. The first step is to just create the basic form. And this is the main form. I've named it Tax Calculator. I've got a text field here. It's named Income. I've got a button here, Calculate Your Tax, and that's called Calc Tax. And then I have a Quit button. The second step is to actually create another form. When the user clicks Calculate Your Tax, it's going to bring up a secondary form. So now, in addition to my tax calculator main form that I just showed you, I've got a single or married form that I just created, and I'm calling this single or married. If I want, I can change the caption up here. I'm just going to actually delete that caption. And this is going to be the form that pops up when the user selects Calculate Your Tax. So the single or married user form has two buttons. It has a single button and a married filing jointly button. It's also got a return button that will return you back to the main form. We've set up the user forms. We formatted it to our specifications. And now we're going to actually code the buttons. I like to start with the quit button. The quit button, you double click on the border. It brings up what you need to code. And if we're just quitting, we can do unload tax calculator. What that does is it removes everything and then basically shuts it down. The next button is the calculate your tax button. When the user clicks calculate your tax, we want a secondary button to appear. So if I double click on that, you'll notice that I've coded this single or married dot show. So singled or married is the second user form that's going to pop up. So when they click this button, it's going to show that single or married form. Now let's work with the single or married form. The return is going to be easy. So the return is just going to be single or married dot hide. We don't want to use unload because unload will actually wipe away anything that they input in this form. But when they click return, that's just going to hide this form and return to tax calculator. There are different equations you can look up in tax tables depending upon if you're single or married filing jointly and depending upon your income, how much you pay. So when they click the single button, this is what is going to happen. You see up here we have single button.click. So this private sub is what happens when they click on the single button. And I've dimmed some things here. Those are things that are defined within this private sub. You'll see I'm using this adjusted income and I have to dim that. But then I'm using this taxcalculator.income. Tax calculator is basically tells the editor where income is coming from. Income was defined on the tax calculator form. Because the code that I'm working on is not in this tax calculator user form, it's actually in the single or married user form, I have to put this tax calculator out in front of it because that tells us which form or which object am I getting that income from. If this tax calculator were left off, this wouldn't work. The adjusted income is just the tax calculator.income. That's what they enter, minus 5,700. You go through, depending upon what that adjusted income is, you have different tax brackets. So if you're making less than 8,375 adjusted income, it's only 10% tax, and so on. At the end of that, there's a message box that says your tax this year is the tax, and I have tax paid. I'm formatting that to zero places after the decimals. The married filing jointly is similar. It's just you have a different adjusted income, and then we have different tax brackets here for married filing jointly. And at the end, we output that in a message box. So everything's set up. We've linked the different forms. We've coded the buttons, and now everything's ready to go. So let's go over to Excel. I've also put a button on here, developer insert button. I formatted it. So when I click go, it brings up the user form. I can put in my income as I showed you at the beginning, and that's how it works. And it tells you your tax. You can repeat this and so on.